When I first came across the Proton Pass versus NordPass comparison, it was kind of a tough riddle to solve. Both providers have some really strong pros and only a few legitimate downsides, but still, which one is better for you? So I'm going to answer this question in this video by doing the most comprehensive Proton Pass versus NordPass review. All right, when it comes to cybersecurity tools, their origin is pretty important. Proton Pass Password Manager is one of the Proton AG products. This is the company responsible for the whole Proton lineup, from the secure email service to a VPN. Proton AG has always been a reputable company, and their attitude toward complete transparency, dedication to keeping their apps open source, and really just having a strong rapport with their community are hard to beat. However, NordPass is not a one-off product either. It's a child of Nord Security, most famous for NordVPN, but also related to a bunch of other cybersecurity tools. Nord Security's reputation is on par with Proton AG, with little to no controversy related to their operations. Purely from the reputational angle, there's basically no major differences between the two, but the same can't necessarily be said about security. Don't get me wrong, a lot of security features are practically identical between NordPass and ProtonPass. For instance, they both follow zero-knowledge architecture, meaning all the passwords in the app are known only to you. The provider's cloud storage only keeps their encrypted versions. The first major difference becomes clear when discussing encryption. So ProtonPass uses a standard but reliable encryption algorithm. NordPass, however, relies on a newer algorithm with better, actually, long-term viability. Another difference concerns privacy and security proofs. For instance, NordPass has passed a system and organization control audit to prove its high level of security, while ProtonPass was examined by Cure53, which found a decent amount of weak points. Not to worry though, ProtonPass have fixed all the issues almost immediately, clearly explaining what the issues were. See? Transparency, remember? So to add to the differences, while both providers have two-factor authentication and even biometric options, only NordPass allows for multi-factor authentication to stack those security measures on top of each other. Furthermore, NordPass security is boosted with automatic backups, which ProtonPass misses. And on the contrary, ProtonPass is completely open source, unlike NordPass. So when it comes to security, ProtonPass is just a little bit more transparent than NordPass, but I argue that the latter does an overall better job in protecting my passwords. So if you want a reliable password manager to protect your passwords, you can try either NordPass or ProtonPass with a special discount. Just click the link in the description or scan one of these QR codes. Now, so far I've covered only the basic security level. Both providers offer additional best password manager level features that can make or break the user experience. For instance, password generator. This is a vital feature for any password manager, and both providers implement it differently. So NordPass limits the maximum password length to 64 characters with in-depth customization on what elements like numbers, special characters, and those sort of things should be included while customizing. ProtonPass only allows adding special characters, and the maximum generation length is 64 characters. As a result, NordPass creates stronger passwords, but not every website needs full symbol variety. So the ProtonPass generation is also far from bad. Now, both providers can also point out weak or reused passwords in my vaults. Now, password health checking is great, and I like how I can change these inadequate passwords with one click while also using the password generator. NordPass's feature is a bit more paranoid though, as it also marks passwords that were unchanged for more than 90 days. I don't think most users need to change their passwords that often, but it's a good practice to do so to avoid security issues. So once I make sure my passwords are strong and unique, the next feature that comes in handy is autofill. Why copy-paste your complex passwords when NordPass Chrome extension can just fill them in immediately? Well, almost immediately. NordPass takes a single click, but ProtonPass takes a bit longer. Plus, I've noticed it's a bit inconsistent. Apparently, Reddit users have reported issues with ProtonPass autofill as well, so just keep that in mind. All right, NordPass and ProtonPass both offer measures to detect data leaks associated with my accounts, but they work a bit differently. So NordPass checks if my emails, saved passwords, or credit cards have been exposed to known data breaches. This also includes custom monitoring, breach categorizations, and email alerts. ProtonPass does pretty much the same, but it specifically scans the dark web for exposed personal data and sends an alert if it finds anything. Okay, next up, password sharing. NordPass users can only share passwords with other NordPass users, whether they want to send one password or have a shared password vault. There's also an option to share passwords through their website, but I prefer app-based sharing for security reasons. Now, ProtonPass allows sharing one-time links to stored passwords with any recipient, so whether they have a ProtonPass account or not. One more common feature is passkeys support. Passkeys are essentially a password alternative. Instead of requiring your logins or passwords, websites can receive a unique login generated by the password manager based on the device's secure authentication. This makes logging in much faster and more secure, but sadly, not every website supports passkeys as a login method just yet. All right, while so far all these features were similar between providers, NordPass does have a few unique ones. Now, for instance, it offers an emergency access feature. This helps a lot since I can designate my family members as emergency users. So if I'm not available for some reason, they can gain read-only access to my passwords. Don't worry though, I'm not going anywhere, but hey, can't be too careful. Additionally, NordPass comes with 3 gigabytes of secure encrypted storage. Yeah, it's not a lot in the grand scheme of things, but I did manage to store dozens of sensitive files in the cloud storage without hitting the limit of 50 files of any type, even once. All right, that said, ProtonPass does claim that a similar feature is coming up, so if it's already released when you watch, that means that I've just got another video to make. Overall, since ProtonPass is a newer password manager, it might have more features and overtake NordPass going forward, but as of now, NordPass is a more versatile option. All right, before discussing pricing of each provider, I want to take a quick peek at ease of use and compatibility. Currently, both NordPass and ProtonPass support all the major OS, you know, both desktop and mobile ones. Browser extensions also cover all the most used browsers and provide an easy way to access most of the features. Now, keep in mind, if you want to use autofill on desktop devices, browser extensions are mandatory. That said, all other features are perfectly available in the apps. All right, now let's discuss pricing. To set things clear, first, both NordPass and ProtonPass do have free versions, and I recommend you skip both of them, okay? Sure, yes, if your goal is to test things out and to get a feel for the apps, go for it. Otherwise, you're just setting yourself up for a mediocre experience devoid of most of the features. Now, as for premium plans, ProtonPass is a bit more expensive, even with the recent 50% price cut. Yeah, they reduced prices, I know. I'm almost shocked. Still, NordPass plans are a bit cheaper in comparison anyway. And since you can also get an exclusive discount to put the price even lower, yeah, that's good value. So what's the conclusion? All right, in my opinion, while comparing ProtonPass versus NordPass, it really becomes clear that they both are extremely solid options. Still, NordPass is a little bit more versatile overall, on top of being a more affordable provider. So that said, ProtonPass does stand out as a very transparent manager with solid security and features, especially if you already have other Proton products, since they do have a certain synergy. All right, so there it is. Tell me, what's your password manager, ProtonPass or NordPass? Let me know in the comments below, and make sure to leave a like and subscribe if you found the video useful. Thanks for watching. I'll see you soon. Bye.